Now checking with Nurcan Baysal. She's a Kurdish journalist from Diyarbakir in the Kurdish region of Turkey. Thank you very much for speaking to us here on France 24. Of course, we'll be coming back to you throughout the program. Now, as Jasper just mentioned, our correspondent in Ankara, one of the main questions in today's election was whether the HDP, the pro-Kurdish party, is going to break this 10% barrier, because if it does, that would allow it to take seats in parliament, meaning that Erdogan's AK party will lose its majority, making it certainly harder for him to put his imprint on policy and power.
Yeah, in fact, it's not a very, very big question in the region, because in the region, people believe that HDP will pass the 10% threshold, because it seems that I was also just coming from the election stations, and in most of the ballot boxes in Diyarbakir, HDP far ahead. So I think in the next few hours we will see that HDP will pass the 10% election, 10% threshold. It is so important, because I think in these elections the Kurdish voice will dictate the Turkish fate. So it is really so important for the HDP to pass the 10% threshold, not just for Kurdish people, but for all Turkey. And I believe that if we can secure our votes, if we can secure the ballot boxes, because we have a lot of questions about it, if we can secure it, HDP can, I think, pass the 10% threshold. But we have real security problems in the region now. As maybe you know, thousands of ballot boxes were reallocated. And today, it is really, we took a lot of different news from the rural areas of Kurdish region that a lot of people couldn't reach the ballot boxes.
Now, you seem extremely optimistic that the HDP will secure this 10% of the vote. But of course, if it doesn't, and our correspondent in Ankara mentioned this, there is talk of people taking to the streets.
If people believe that they rigged the votes, I think they will go to the streets. You know, and if HDP couldn't pass the 10% threshold, I think it will be so hard for not for only Kurdish people, but for all Turkey, because Turkey can come to a point that never return again. And one man, despotic governance, you know, will dictate Turkey. And so I think, yes, if people believe that they rigged their votes, and maybe they can go to the streets. We don't know. It is really, everything is so unclear now. It is so unclear also in Diyarbakir. But as I learned from a lot of journalists who are working in Diyarbakir, in most of the ballot boxes in Diyarbakir and in Kurdish region, it seems that HDP is far ahead. But we will see.
And Nurcan,
but you know, at the beginning, usually Anadolu Agency is a pro-government agent, and usually at the beginning, in every election, they do it. First, they usually count the votes coming from the pro-AKP places and districts.
Now, Nurcan, you and I spoke earlier, and you were on your way to some polling stations, you mentioned. How has security been in the Kurdish region this Sunday?
Yeah, the thing is that we are in the city centers. In the city centers, there are some problems, but not big problems. But in the rural areas of Kurdish region, there are really, really big problems, because a lot of ballot boxes, they reallocated. And thousands of Kurdish villagers should need to walk to their ballot boxes, sometimes 40 kilometers away. And the new places of the ballot boxes are usually, they put the ballot boxes to the villages, which we have the paramilitaries, village guards. And they also change their places to pro-AKP villages. So it is really hard, because in the rural areas near the ballot boxes, we have the arms, because we have soldiers with arms, and we have paramilitaries with arms. And so there is a lot of pressure, especially in the rural areas. But unfortunately, we don't have any election observers in the rural areas. And today in Diyarbakir and in the region, the election observers who came from the other countries were detained. So, you know, I think the problem is in the rural areas, not in the city centers.
Nurcan Baysal reporting there from Diyarbakir. We will be coming back to you later on in the program with your latest updates from the Kurdish region in Turkey. Now,